question. You're from Granite Rock.
I am.
Skip Murphy.
I am.
And you may not entirely agree with Dr. Paul.
Not entirely. Certainly, I believe that a lot of his issues, especially the fiscal issues, have become much more mainstream than what was the case in the last cycle. I think there are a number of social issues where I, as conservative, but with a few libertarian leanings, but only leanings, kind of part ways with Ron Paul on the social issues and perhaps on the defense of America issues. You know, one of the things that I'm here tonight is to see if he's going to elaborate on his answer about Iran and the bomb and how that extends out to other, perhaps, allies in a hypothetical standpoint. What if it wasn't just Israel that had been threatened by Iran? What if it was Britain? What if it was Canada or Australia or some other country to which we are allies? What is our, under a Ron Paul presidency, what is the foreign policy for our allies, given that Ron Paul wants to bring all of the military back in? And somewhat say, if you guys want to fight, go fight amongst yourselves. So I'm interested to see how that would happen. And I think a lot of conservatives are waiting to hear an expanded answer of what was given in a very short amount of time.
Very good. Thank you, Skip Murphy.
You're quite welcome.
And we'll look for your report on Granite Rock.
Indeed.
Great. Thanks.
A little while ago. So we'll see.
A reasonably safe child.
Yeah.
And cute.
I have to worry too much, hopefully.
Crowd, as many people call us, we'll do anything, right? And we know why. And then there's the third reason, which I think is the most important reason. Liberty is popular. It's really that simple. See people running around with clipboards, there's sign-up sheets. We need lots of phone calls. If you can spare 10 minutes, 20 minutes, an hour a day, come down here, make phone calls. They've made it easy. You make a lot of phone calls, they might even feed you. Come on, we need your help. We're going to do door knocking.
We have to turn this thing around. We have to turn this thing around now. And there's only one man I trust to do that, and that's Congressman Ron Paul. Congressman Ron Paul.
Here and there, and they always say, well, come to the headquarters, the volunteers are going to be there. Well, I always expect at least 30 or 40 people. So when I was driving up, I was rather impressed, I'll tell you.
I think that is a perfect example because, you know, if we took all of his beliefs and all of our beliefs, I'll bet also the reason why I'm so encouraged. Because, you know, at times I've been criticized. Allow our system of government and our republic to be destroyed. That is what we have to reverse, because it is out of hand, it is out of control, and I think the people know it. And I think this is...
some people here who want to talk to Ron Paul and maybe take a picture. So he will be standing up by the campaign door. Don't rush him right now. No, I'm talking to you. Don't rush him right now.
If you want to ask him to say Mr. Bernardi in the election.
Oh, he was at the veterans?
Yeah, he actually was when we showed up.
How do you surge back into this, or are you already into this? Do you think Harry's talking about Rami and Rami's talking about Harry?
What do you
think? I'm not talking about Rami.
Here at the grand opening of the Concord headquarters.
Yeah, absolutely. We had over 330 RSVP, but there was well over 500, 550 was one of the counts, but there's probably even more than that, probably upwards of 600 people, so it was a great turnout. We're really happy with it.
Hey, you're really working hard and you're busting the sweat even on a nice night.
Yeah,
like this.
I'm busting the sweat here when it's, you know, a little humid, but hard work, but it's going to be a different campaign this time. We're going to work really hard. It's going to be fantastic.
You are the man, Chris. Thank you.
Thank you.
He's a real kind of, I'm wondering.